Now we will learn how to make time slips for associate lawyers. This way, we can track our attorney's hours by client. Now, you may well ask, what is a time slip? Well, it's a document that you make to keep track of how much time each associate attorney worked on each client. Technically, it is not a transaction, so be careful. It will not show up in the journal because it's not a transaction. It's an event we document that will become a transaction after we place it on an invoice and bill the client. It has its own separate reports. You can only find time slips you recorded on the specific time-related reports that we use. There's no other way to find them. So you may well ask, what information is on a time slip? Well, of course we're going to put the date the person worked, the name of the person who worked. You're going to put which job or which client the attorney worked on. But more importantly, if you're going to mark this time slip as billable, then you must put a service item on the time slip if you're going to bill the client for this time. Time slips can be for employees or for vendors. An independent contractor is a vendor on the vendors list. Our example will use independent contractors on the vendor list. However, you should know the time slips can be used with employees and it can be used to determine time for employees, but that would only be possible if you purchased a payroll subscription. So that's why in our example, we'll only imagine or assume that our attorneys who work in our law firm are independent contractors on the vendors list. So, let's first add the two time-related reports to the icon bar so that when we make a timesheet, we can know where to find them. The first report is the time by job detail, and when we put it up, we're going to modify it so that we can add some notes. So, from the main menu, we click Reports, and we click Jobs, Time, and Mileage. And the first one is Time by Job Detail. Time by Job Detail. Is that the one? Yep, yes it is. Now, of course we push A for all, but we have to modify this a bit. It's better to add the column for notes. So we click Customize Report and tell QuickBooks, scroll down a little and click Notes. Click OK, and now it added this column because the notes in a time slip might be very important to describe information about what happened in that time event. You should also move the mouse here to the three dots and click and drag and make the column wider. And you should do that before you put it in the icon bar. In fact, you could even change the name, Time by Client Detail. Time by Client. Okay, click OK. Now that it looks the way we need it to look, we click View, add Time by Job to the icon bar, and then in the label of the icon bar, put Time by Client Detail and click OK. And now we can click the icon bar and it will open immediately and look exactly the way we need it to look. Now let's do the other report, Time by Name. From the main menu, click Reports, Jobs, Time, and Mileage, Time by Name. Of course, we're going to push A for all and we'll put the from date and to date on a case-by-case basis after we open it up. But for now, we click View and add Time by Name to the icon bar and click OK. Now we're all set up to start entering time slips. Now, because we're not using the payroll module, Let's add the two associate attorneys to the vendor list. We will add Ben the barrister and Lana the lawyer. Are you ready? From the main menu, click Vendor, Vendor Center. Then click New Vendor, New Vendor. Ben, let's make it capital. Ben the barrister. And then we click OK. And then we can add New Vendor, Lana the lawyer. And then we click OK. Good. Now we have them on the list and we're ready to enter our first time slip. First, we'll enter April 20. Lana did 8 hours on the Allen Arby job and it's not billable because I want you to see the difference between billable and non-billable in the reports. So to enter the time slip, we can click Customer, Enter Time, Time Single Activity, because a time slip is a single activity. And we open it up and we just put the information. We go back to April 20 and we put who worked. In this case, Ben. Was it Ben? No, it was Lana. In this case, it was Lana. And it was on the Allen Arby job. And remember, we must put the service item that we did. Now, in our course, we only have one service item that we list on an invoice, legal services rendered. That's it. And then we put the number of hours, 8. In the notes, we can put anything that's helpful. Wow, Alan is a difficult client. You can put whatever you want, whatever you need. I'm just putting it for example. But we will not mark it as billable, okay? So if it's not marked as billable, we can just click. Actually, if it's not marked as billable, I recommend that you leave the service item blank. And then we just click Save and Close. And then ignore any spelling issues that we have. Now you can see Time by Name has Lana. And if we open up Lana, you can see she worked on the Allen job. But if we do Time by Client, you can see Allen has Lana as 8 hours. And you could even see the notes that she wrote. You can reopen the time slip by opening the report and double-clicking right on the slip. Actually, if you click here, you get another one, and then you can just double-click, and then you go right back to the slip, and you can change anything you need. And you can go back to the slip from either of the reports. If we click here and here, you go right back to the slip, and you can change it. Once you change it, the results in the reports will change immediately. Now, let's record April 21. Ben did 5 hours for Betty Boop, and in this case, it's billable. So we, again, customers, enter time, single activity. In this case, it's April 21. Okay. In this case, it was Ben who did the work. The customer was Betty Boop. And because we are marking it as billable, we must choose a service item. And of course, in a real law firm, you might have more than one service item because you might want to track the separate services and your income separately. But in our case, there's only one service item on the list, so we put the item that he did, and we put 5 hours. And we can put some notes that help us. Betty is a good client. Whatever you want to put that relates to this event in the notes. When we click Save and Close, you can see Time by Client detail. Betty has Ben's work. We can stretch out the name a bit. Betty, on the Allen job, we had Lana. On the Betty job, we had Ben. And we have their notes, and we have the date that they worked and the number of hours that they worked and any other detail that they wish to record. This one is not billable, and this one is unbilled. Now, of course, you can go time by name, and you can see that Ben's total time is only 5, Lana's total time is only 8, but this report tells you what's unbilled and not. So let's just record two more to get the idea. April 22, Lana did 4 hours for Betty Boop, and it is billable. So what do? We open the time slips again. Customers enter time, single activity. In this case, it was April 22, and the name of the worker was Lana. And the name of the job she was on this time was Betty. And this time, Betty's work is billable, or Lana's work is billable to Betty. So we have to put the service item, and we have to put some notes that describe it so that we can uniquely identify it. And the number of hours in this case was 4. Okay? Save and close. Ignore all the spelling issues. And now time by client detail. Now look, you can see, if you look at time by client, you can see that these were the dates. Let's open up the name a little bit more here. These were the dates that the workers worked for Betty. These were the lawyers that worked for Betty. And these are the number of hours they worked on those dates. And you can see that it is billable to Betty, and we have not yet billed it. But if you look at time by name, you can see Lana worked on 2 different jobs, and that's the total hours for Anna, and Ben only worked on 1. So now, April 23rd, Ben did 6 hours for Alan, and it's not billable. So again, we open up the time slip the way we did. This date was April 23rd. The worker, or the lawyer in this case, was Ben. The customer was Alan. And we don't have to put service item or billable because Alan's isn't billable. So you just put 6. And then, of course, don't put an invalid character by accident. And then, blah, 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 blah with the notes. Save and close. Ignore all. Yeah. Now, time by client, you can see Alan had 2 workers working for him this week, 8 hours of Alana and 6 hours of Ben. So the total that Alan service that Alan got was 14 hours, but that's not billable. We're not going to put that on an invoice. But with Betty, you can see that these 2 lawyers worked. You can see the dates that they worked, how many hours they worked specifically for Betty, and that they are billable. And if it's time to pay the worker, you go time by name, and you could see, Ben worked a total of 11 hours, and here are the jobs he worked on. And Betty worked a total of 12, Lana worked a total of 12 hours, and here's the job. So these 2 reports break down everything you need regarding time. Now, on April 24th, we billed Betty only for Ben's time. So how does that work? Well, it's very simple. We open an invoice. Now, we have to put the date April 24th. But now watch this. At the moment we choose Betty, this is a normal message. If this doesn't come up, then you would have to click the Add Time and Cost here. But you don't have to click it, because as soon as we choose Betty, this pops up. Do you want to select the outstanding billable time? Click OK. Now, we were here earlier with expenses, and we come here for time. And again, we're only billing for Ben's time today. So we click here to select Ben, the 5 hours that he did on April 21. We're asking Betty to pay on April 24th. When we click OK, notice the item that was on the time slip comes onto the invoice. Now all we have to do is put what we bill for Ben, in this case $33 an hour. So he's getting, we were asking Betty to pay $165. So that's all you have to do. And again, if the time doesn't pop up, you click this and then you select it. Okay, very good. Now when we click Save and Close, remove this and then click Save and Close. Okay, no, we'll apply the credits later. Now first, Let's take a look by time by client. You can see that this one was billed and this one was not billed. So that's the difference in the report after you put it on a time slip. And this is the only way to tell what time was and was not billed. But the good news is this. If you look at the client balance detail for Betty, you can see there's another invoice for $165 added to Betty's balance. And of course, the numbers in the trial balance change accordingly. We now have more unearned legal fees because we just billed Betty for the time that Ben spent. So just to finish the example, let's imagine on April 25th, we billed Betty for Lana's time, and she gets paid, or we bill her out, at $44 an hour. And we do the same thing. We click, well, first let's look at this report. Remember, so far Lana's time is unbilled for Betty. Okay, watch this. We click invoice, and now again, we're going to put the 25th, and we're going to choose Betty. Aha! Again, if this doesn't pop up, just click this button here and it will pop up. But it did, so we click OK, and we just select the remaining time. That's it. Click OK, and now it's on the invoice. Remember, she gets billed out at $44 an hour. Push tab. So Lana now has to pay $176 Betty has to pay us $176 for the time that Lana spent. When we click save and close, you got to remember to remove this. But when we click save and close and click ignore all, okay. Now take a look. Both of these now say billed because we now billed the client for those specific time slips. You could go back to it and it'll say billed right on the slip. And to make sure we know that it's billed, when we click the client balance detail for Betty, we can see her balance has gone up for the invoice from what we asked her to pay for Lana's hours.